We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello, and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time, we're looking at Iron Sights from Splatto Comics. Story by Richard C. Meyer and Carlos Silva. Script by Richard C. Meyer. Interior art and back cover by Ibe Canales. Front cover by Kelsey Shannon. Now, this is an interesting graphic novel. It follows the adventures of a sniper who got out of the military and seems to be kind of bored, so he's taken up to border duty guarding these guys working on oil rigs or something, and he comes across some people that are about to execute a woman. He ends up taking them out from over the border, which is an international incident, obviously, and because he's in the National Guard reserves, it may literally start a war. The cartel guys think that somebody else did it, and they come looking for that guy. His name's Woods. Eventually, Woods and Ramadi's paths cross, and things get really bloody really fast. This is very much an adult book. It's a story of revenge and boredom and people that like killing things. So it's a very violent, adult, mature title. There is some language that could be seen as incredibly objectionable. Bad language, obviously. Very gory. Now, the art style has a very indie feel, but it's actually really effective. If you liked Mother Russia by Alterna, it's a very similar art style, and it's pretty good, actually. It's got kind of a raw feel, and it really works for an indie book like this. Now, this is a very quick read, shockingly, considering that it is a graphic novel. It actually has very, very good pacing, which really surprised me, actually. I thought it would be a little more rough, but it actually has a very professional feel. It doesn't feel like an indie book. It feels like somebody that's been working on comics for a long time. And the dialogue is pretty solid. It flows really well. It's sort of a grindhouse meets western feel to it. It gives it a very modern spaghetti western feel. I really liked that, actually. I thought it was a lot of fun. There aren't a lot of likable people in this book. Almost everybody is doing something shady or they're killing people, but it just keeps going. It's just very fast-paced and action-oriented, and I really liked that because there's enough to keep you from getting bored. Every time something seems like they're gonna get all dialogue-y, nope, they jump right back into gunplay and people getting their heads blown off. So there's no screwing around. They really dig right in and stick to the theme, and it had an ending that I didn't really expect. And wow, the body count is huge in this. But overall, great book. I really like the cover. Kelsey Shannon's a very talented artist. Canales did a good job with his style. It's a very specific style that's not going to appeal to everyone, but it was fun. It worked really well for the book. It definitely has that like indie look to it that I think they were doing on purpose. It really worked for it. So I'm not going to complain about the art style. It's not really my style that I would typically like, but it worked really well, just like in Mother Russia and some of the other indie stuff that you've seen over the years. So if you're into like grindhouse movies, or if you saw Last Man Standing with Bruce Willis and like that, you'll like this. It has that same kind of tone of there's not a lot of good guys here. There's just a bunch of people killing each other. So it was really fun. I enjoyed it quite a bit. I'm going to recommend it. If you can find a copy, definitely pick it up. The paper quality is actually really good. The interior paper was actually better than I expected. I thought it'd be more like newsprint, but it's not the highest end, but it's definitely not cheap either. And it's got real nice, smooth cover. I'm impressed by the quality of it. It looks incredibly professional for the early outing for a company that most people have never heard of. So if you can find it, if it gets reprinted, definitely check it out. I think this was a low print run book, so it might be kind of hard to track down, but if you come across a copy, definitely give it a chance. It was a fun book. I'm glad I got a copy. I thought it was a lot of fun, and it was a fun read, and I'm definitely going to reread it over and over again because it's got that movie quality to it. It definitely has a very cinematic flair and a very high violence and body count. So if you like action movies, that sort of thing, you'll like this. It definitely has a very grindhouse feel to it. Like I said, it's a grindhouse movie mixed with like a modern spaghetti western, and it really worked for me. I enjoyed it quite a bit, but that's just my take. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like and consider subscribing so you don't miss future reviews. And if you want to support the channel, Patreon links and Teespring links are in the description and on the about page. And we hope to see you on the next one.